Lawrence, let me explain something. It's not that women shouldn't be free to wear whatever they want. Let me put it a different way so it's very straightforward. First example, we'll call it the water argument. If we're in the desert, and a bunch of mediocre people and evil people have a ton of water bottles, and you're a hot chick and you smile at them and you pour them some water, okay? And the wisest and the best is dehydrated on his way out, and you're not pouring him any water, okay? And then you have a shirt on that says, I love water. Should we then say, hey, you know, she can wear whatever she wants. She can choose to pour the water for wherever she wants. Or do we say your path is inferior? The combination of your behavior, you know, the total sum of your behavior is deplorable. And you should have your free will taken away. And someone should tell you who to pour water for, so to speak, right? You basically should be told, should be made to change your behavior. And so it is with the admiration of potential wives. For example, with the AIDS argument, let's say for the sake of argument that AIDS stands for Alpha ID and backwards Die Alpha, for the sake of argument, for nothing else. And people came together to give the wisest and the best and the most athletic people AIDS, and so they die, so that these people in turn could then win the Olympics and the token minorities they have groomed to see it their way. Okay? Should those token minorities and these people who have been practicing evil breeding and romantic injustice for generations, generational romantic injustice, should they then be given the rewards, money, sponsorship, and the admiration of potential wives? So it is with how Santa Cruz, which is just another city in the country, is cheating me. You know, I happen to be rather fond of this city to a certain extent, but they are cheating me nonetheless. Okay? So it is with the way they dress. It's not that I don't want them to dress that way so much. I don't want them to take the government's side and cheat me, especially after all my family has done every generation, not just my dad with $300,000 a year in free service to the community, okay? Which overlaps with the Santa Cruz community to some degree. But since we came up with martial arts as the people that made man stand up as the true civilizers of humanity, giving them moral, focused moral intensity through martial arts, through African martial arts, as civilization. It is beyond cruel, wicked, and deplorable for them to do that. Now, we must also consider that these people are building the infrastructure of an immoral state, a state that refuses to practice governance correctly. They don't seem to understand moral clarity, moral governance, moral will, moral responsibility. They are not responding to the situation. The responsibility is deplorable. If my child was in charge at 3 years, you know, we'll say at 10 years old, I would punish him severely if he didn't address this situation immediately. I would hold a 10-year-old child to the same standard as they would, as I would to them, okay, in this regard. It's not that hard to understand, okay? When people refuse to transcend the boundaries of an immoral state that can't even make this basic human decency related decision, you know, judgment call, and set the stage for this guy to be rewarded and compensated immediately. If they can't even transcend that, they have no business having free will. It needs to be taken away and they need to submit immediately. If you do not have the bravery, the goodness of heart, the discernment of heart, the courage, the sense of justice and fair play to stop shunning this guy, you should have your free will taken immediately. Now, even if you have not heard of me. Why? Because the culture that you're in, you know, is the type of culture that shuns these types of guys. Do you think the white conservatives are going to be like, oh yeah, when you find the African hero, you should date him immediately? No, they want to conserve their race first and foremost. Do you think the liberals are saying, hey, you know, when you find the focused moral intensity in the most masculine person that ever lived, for example, in terms of the essence of masculinity, which is the spirit of moral masculinity, if you will, virtue, ver meaning man, the true virtue, true masculinity, true manhood. When you see this in the ideal man, who happens to be a mixed black man from an African patriarchal line, you should forsake your culture and your father's house, in a sense, culturally, right? And honor morality. Their very culture screams that they would do this to me. So they could be a white liberal vegan with their white little boyfriend. So they could be a minority liberal, you know, average liberal person with their minority boyfriend. In their despicable cultural context. any culture that teaches its people to not prioritize moral supremacy and the true moral order is sickening. It is disgusting. It is irresponsible. It is childish. It is evil. Now look at how these people are walking. Again, you think I planned this? You think I told these people, hey, walk, I'm making a video, so walk, you know. Everywhere I go, I can tell by how people walk that I could outmaneuver them quickly. I can tell, you see all that guy in the red shirt, for example, they're wearing a red jacket, you know, plaid jacket. Okay, you can tell that if I started moving quickly and started doing skywalking quickly, see my skywalking video, I made a playlist for it, that he wouldn't last a second. I'd outmaneuver him, I'd stab him 100 times. He's done. It has to do with his lack of intensity. He's an older gentleman. Now, I have nothing against that guy. Probably a nice guy, probably a great guy. Probably share a beer with him when I was younger. But you get what I'm saying. Okay? This stuff goes without saying. As easy as it is to quickly come to that conclusion, it is that simple to come to the conclusion of which culture you should be a part of and what your arguments should be. You should have a more romantic, mental, moral, and spiritual imperative with no generational romantic injustice, bitch. Anyone who rewards people with their bodies and their sex for generational romantic injustice when they're an attractive person with all kinds of options should be executed. Really, I'm not saying go kill them, but that's what they deserve. They should be imprisoned. Anyone who doesn't acknowledge the true scale of the moral order, okay, and live by it should be imprisoned until they can live accordingly. This profoundly intense moral injustice, you know, immoral injustice, if you will, is unacceptable. It is deplorable. It is beneath even primates.